Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Sri Swami Indian Academy. Today we are going to learn about some of the psychrometric processes. In the earlier video, I have shown you how to locate a point on a psychrometric chart, what is the psychrometric chart, how to use it, how it is drawn, where the properties can be located, that we have already seen. Now today we will see some of the processes on the psychrometric chart. Now let us see what are the things we are going to learn today. That is what sensible heating, then you go for sensible cooling, then humidification, dehumidification. Let us start with the sensible heating process. So sensible heating. Now what do you mean by sensible heating? As you see, the name already suggests it is a sensible one. Sensible heat is generally when you supply or remove heat sensibly, you will get a difference in temperature. That temperature goes on decrease or increase. Okay, that temperature goes to be changed. Now what is mean by sensible heating? In this case, the sensible heating is nothing but the process where you transfer the heat or give the heat to the air without changing its specific humidity or its humidity ratio. That means sensible heating is nothing but heating air change in specific humidity is not allowed here. There should not be change in specific humidity of the air when you go to heat the air. What do you mean by specific humidity? Already discussed. What is the specific humidity? That is the amount of water present in the dry air. So that is amount of water present in the dry air should not change. That means during the heating process, water should not be added or water should not be removed from the air. So let us see how you can achieve this. Let us say I have certain container. It is, let us say, insulated. And let us say I am having a heating coil. This is the heating coil. Some air is coming from this side. Let us say this is air. It's coming from this side. Let us see the air temperature is dry bulb temperature DB1. Okay. And it is coming out after heating. It will be dry bulb temperature TB2. Okay. And let us say the temperature of this cooling coil is TDB3. Okay. So if you see this process, air is passed over the coil. It is coming out of the coil. During this, no water particles are added or no water particles are taken out. That means specific humidity will not going to change. Now if you see here, what is that? Dry bulb temperature of the incoming air is less than dry bulb temperature of outgoing air. So this will be hot. So you can say that TDB2 is greater than TDB1. Again, one more interesting thing is the coil temperature is more than this. Why it is so? If the efficiency of transfer of heat is 100%, then this temperature is equal to air temperature. Whatever the air will pass through the coil, that will take the 100% heat and that will be reached to TDB3. But here the process, let us say, no process is 100% efficient. That means this coil temperature is more than this temperature coming out of this. That means TdV3 is greater than TdV2. Okay, this is what? Sensible heating process. Now let us see that process on psychrometric chart. Very famous chart, very useful chart. If you see, this is like this. Now you know, here you are getting dry bulb temperature. Let us say this is TdV1. As you know, it is smaller than everyone. Then TdV2 is slightly greater than this one, and TdV3 is slightly greater than that one. Okay. Now this is the specific humidity lines. You see specific humidity. Okay, let us say the specific humidity for this particular incoming air is already known. That is, specific humidity is already known. That is some, let us say, some phi. Okay, so that is already known. Let us say here. So what is this? Is TdV1. So the first thing is here, point number one. So I am having point number one here. Then second is TdV2. This one again, specific humidity is not going to change, so it is here, point number two. And again third one, this one is again here, specific humidity is same. This is point number three. So what is the process actually? The process is 1, 2 is the process. 1, 2, 2 is the process, and 3 is nothing but the temperature of heating coil. So if you see, the sensible heating line is horizontal line on the psychrometric chart. Now let us see sensible cooling. Sensible cooling. Now what is sensible cooling? Again, it is cooling the air without changing its specific humidity. So again, cooling air without changing specific humidity. Now if you see here, some air with dry bulb temperature going in, this is TdV3, some is coming out with TdV2. Now it is a cooling process. Let us say this is the cooling coil. Now this is cooling coil, cooling coil. Now that means what? The temperature of this air is less than this one. It is cooling. Again, this coil has lowest temperature. This has lowest temperature. As in case of sensible heating, it is highest. This is the lowest temperature. So that means what? You can say that here in this case, you will get, sorry, TdV3 is lowest than TdV2, and it is lowest than TdV1. So it is lower than TdV1. So TdV1 is greater one, TdV2 is greater than, this is TdV3. So you can say TdV1 is here, 2 is here, and 3 here. So you will see here the process is here 1, 2, 3. 1 to 2 is a cooling process without changing the specific humidity. That means this is again a horizontal line, but the temperatures are going to change here. Okay, now let us say the third one, that is called humidification. asking, what do you mean by humidification? Humidification means adding the water into the air without changing its dry bulb temperature. See, here, increasing temperature without changing its water content. Here, increasing its water content without changing its temperature. So, here, the humidification is nothing but increasing its water content without changing its dry bulb temperature. So, how you can achieve that one? Let us see. It can be achieved by using air washers. So, let us say this is a chamber. I can have, there is some water. There is a spray. The spray. And this is run by a motor here, let us see. Okay. So air will come from here. Air will go from here. Now if you see here, what happens? This is nothing but the air washer. What here we are doing is, air coming in and going out from here. During this process, what will happen? The small particles of water are sprayed. And that small particles are absorbed by this air and that will go out. That means you are enriching the water content inside the air. Now, what we are doing is, we are spraying this water having temperature equal to the dry bulb temperature of coming air. That means temperature is not going to increase. At the temperature of this water, spraying water, and the temperature of air is same. So there will be no change in temperature of air. Now this is what called a humidification. So that is nothing but is a vertical line in the psychrometric chart. If you see here, this is the psychrometric chart. The humidification can be done like this. Is point number one. Point number two, it is a vertical line. That is nothing but a humidification. If you see one and two having the same temperature here, temperature is not going to change. But it's, you see, this is H2, this is H1. If you see, enthalpies are changing. Here you are getting enthalpies. Okay, enthalpies are changing, but you see in this process will not get change in dry bulb temperature. This is called humidification. If you think of dehumidification, it is nothing but the removal of water without changing its dry bulb temperature. So that will be processed from 1 to 2, that is downwards. So this is what psychrometric processes, that is the simple psychrometric processes. If you see, there are other processes like heating with humidification, heating with dehumidification, cooling with humidification, or cooling with dehumidification, that are other processes also. Okay, so these are just simple processes I have described. In the next video, I will go for sensible heating with sensible with humidification, cooling with dehumidification, like that. Again, if you see here, I have seen this is sensible. Temperature was going to change in sensible one, but here the temperature is not going to change. So sometimes it can also be called as a latent heat process. This humidification is latent heat process. Okay, done. So if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.